Okay. So I'm going to I guess do a two-handed swing with my longsword.
Okay.
That never mind.
You and that bear just can't hit each other.
The greatest battle ever.
Dun dun. All right. Anything else you want to do?
No. Because when leaving,
Yes.
Okay. Probably not going to do that.
Okay, it is Sirena's turn.
So I'm so pissed that this bear hit me, and I'm just like, okay, or bit me, whatever he did. So I just, like, turn at him and whomp him right in the face again.
Whomp.
Whomp him. Whomp him.
Whomp him. Whomp him good.
Does a 12 whomp him?
A 12 does not whomp him.
Ooh.
Then I slap him with my free hand.
Also, does not whomp.
Oh, no.
That bear is unwompable.
That bear is unwompable.
Unwompable.
Your strikes aren't finding any real hits on him. It doesn't seem to be affecting him.
And then I can still move, correct?
Since I
didn't move in.
Let me check how mobile works. You might have to actually hit.
When you make it... No, it says whether you hit or not.
Okay, then. Yeah, you're good.
Okay, so I'm gonna just back off and just get behind Danny.
Uh-oh.
I think our internet died. Nope.
We didn't mention that on the last combat I was on, I could not get farther off the map than I was.
It is Danny's turn.
Kill the unwompable bear, Danny.
Womp the bears.
And I'll pincushion them. Hopefully.
Oh, yeah.
14 hit?
That definitely hit.
Oh.
Nice. I think
that bear should be dead, because you said he was bleeding, so...
Oh, yeah. It's...
It's D.O.D.
Dead. It falls over with a thump.
Ooh.
Rip in peace.
Ripperoni!
That'll be it for my turn, isn't it?
It is. Cat's turn. As the bear... is bleeding on the ground.
Now, you have two bears on the initiative list.
Do I?
Yes, you have one at 5 and one at 1.
Yeah, and I know.
Okay, so there is obviously one we are missing.
Nah, you don't know that.
I knew that by
baby
the order.
Bear.
It's a baby bear.
He wants his porridge hot.
Oh, is it?
Who's that dragon?
What can I do here?
That dragon was the bear.
Yeah, you could have. Give me one second here. Let me see. I want to see... So, no matter what I do, Vicious Mockery is a action.
Correct.
Okay. So, I want to do Vicious Mockery on that bear. Let's roll that. And you roll your wisdom save.
Yep.
How did we not see this?
How did we not see the dragon? Did it pass or fail?
We will find out.
Oh, it's rolling.
It failed.
Oh, failed miserably. Okay. So, for anyone that doesn't know, Vicious Mockery gives the mob a disadvantage on its next attack. Just a heads up. And then I'm going to move, everybody's moving backwards. This is not fair, guys. I'm going to move here. I'm going to move next to Serena.
Party right in this corner.
There. Party in the corner. Everybody's leaving van. And I am done.
I love increasing chances of my death.
The bear's coming at you again. It is going to have disadvantage on its first attack roll because of that vicious mockery, though.
Oh!
Never mind.
No! It has disadvantage, so it misses.
It takes a 5, so it misses. That was a lucky, 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 lucky thing.
Well, let's see if he can hit you with his claw instead.
15?
15?
Nope.
You dodge out of the way again.
Wow. Wow, Richard. Richard the dexterous one.
And it is Richard's turn.
Hey, yesterday I cut someone in half.
That is true. It is your turn.
Going to do it again.
Kill him! No!
Or not.
Or not.
And you missed!
Like I said, I'll do it again.
You guys are just in a toe-to-toe missing match right now.
I'm gonna slap bite.
And it is Sirena's turn.
Okay, so I'm gonna bustle up to this bear here, right next to Richard, and wallop it, too, just like it did the other one.
I think it was womp it. Womp it.
Womp it with my stick.
No womping.
No womping.
No womping. Okay, I'm going to swipe at it then.
Oh!
Bitch slapped.
Yeah, the slap is really heavy. You knock it right in the nose.
And then I'm going to run back to my original position. Just kind of hang out and be like, all right, slap and run away.
Alrighty. And Danny, it is your turn.
Your turn.
Here's a question. Does her being behind me have a chance of the arrow hitting me?
No.
So it ignores players? Like,
yes.
Okay.
People do things where, like, if you critical fumble, it does, but...
Yeah, if I decided to do that, then maybe, but I usually don't.
Nice!
Oh yeah, the arrow digs into it.
And I'm good here.
And it thumps to the ground again.
2 for 2!
And Cat is up.
We don't see said third bear.
Nope.
Perception check.
Perception check. Hold on, let me pull up my thing. This is a little bit more difficult on a laptop, actually. Perception.
I'm playing on a laptop.
Welcome to my world.
Oh, yeah! How them apples?
You hear rustling from this direction.
Okay. So I would let everybody know I'm hearing more noises coming from the northeast or northwest and kind of make a little bit of way. Should be about there. Start making my way that direction.
Okay, Richard, it is your turn.
Does the rustling sound like a bear in a picnic basket?
Oh, no. You hear echo out from the doctors, hey, boo-boo.
So, I'm assuming I could take my daggers back. What? That.
The one that is sticking out of the bear in front of you, yes. You can lean down and pick it up if you want.
Does that count as anything, or...
No, it's free.
Okay. Then I'm going to move here.
Okay.
And can I see anything else, or is that it?
It's too dark up there for you to see.
Okay. Then that's all I can do.
It is Sirena's turn.
I would follow up towards Richard, so I would end up probably about here. I think it was at 40 out there. And that's the end of my turn.
You can move twice if you don't attack on your turn, if you so choose.
Oh, I didn't know that.
It's a trap. It's a trap.
It's a tarp.
Yeah, no, I probably would come up just even with Richard. Then I wouldn't go, like, too much further ahead. I want to stay with the whole group.
Okay. Danny, it is your turn.
I'm going to move up where was here, and I'll have an action ready. Ready in action as I move closer that way.
Okay.
That'd be an attack action, because I think you have to say what you're readying. Yeah, it's an attack
right.
action.
Right. And you're readying it if you see what?
Something. A bear with a picnic basket pop out.
Gotcha. Okay.
That's mine, dude.
Cat, it is your turn.
I'm trying to explain something to Nikki real quick.
That's fine.
So I'm going to... What could I do?
Get the park ranger.
Yeah, that's where I'm not wanting to go up alone too far ahead of you guys and then be up there dancing with the stupid bear by myself. So, man, what can I do? I guess I'm going to move in front of you guys. Like, I would squeeze up in front of you just to, like, see dark light and come up here and kind of, like, stand there. And then ready an action for using my crossbow. My light crossbow. Because obviously I know something's up here. I heard it. So, yeah. And that would be it.
Okay. Richard, it is your turn.
Oh, okay. I don't know why I keep measuring distance. I'm just going to go here.
Okay. And
I'm assuming that follows the same rule as before, as I can't see anything.
I'll reel a little bit, because you can see a little bit in front of you, but not much.
Okay.
I'm technically next to him. I have 60, so I would maybe be able to see a little bit more. But I don't want to, like, ruin it. So, like, obviously, if the bear's nearby...
There's no ruining.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, I'll give you a little bit more because of you.
Yeah, like I was just saying, like 40 there you or go. Whatever. Yeah, that's fine.
And there's a corner here, so...
Oh, there, okay.
Like...
Yeah, line of sight. I get it.
Right, okay. Sirena...
All right, I will move. Let's see. We'll move up to here. Maybe one more further, right there. And I would stop there, depending on what I see once I get up there.
You're the one with the light, correct?
Yeah.
Correct.
Okay.
She is the 20 and 20.
You can see it.
Could she ready an action, like a melee attack, or is that...
If she'd like to.
Is that but... not something you can do with melee? I know ranged is more preferred, because you can attack as soon as it comes.
You can do it with melee.
Okay. So you may want to do that too, Nick.
This is what you see.
Okay. Oh, but it's just a baby, guys.
Kill it.
You see a small bear, and it's looking at you, and it's making baby bear cub noises.
Aw, we killed its parents. We fucked them up.
We're terrible people.
Oh, great. The murder hobo killed the parents.
Yes.
Take the cub.
Does it look like it's aggressive towards us, or is it just too small to, like, care?
It looks scared, I would say. Not necessarily aggressive.
I would kind of turn back towards Richard since he's the closest, and I would just be like, my nature wouldn't want me to hurt it, but if you guys want to, that's your call.
I love how I'm the go-to person now.
Great.
You're closest.
Van, it was Van before, like, and he'd be like, Jesus saves all.
Can I see if I can
move up?
Dinner.
Yeah, we can consider this out of combat at this point.
Okay, so we kind of...
Danica is going to reach into her pouch and, like, grab a piece of beef jerky or equivalent, you know, and try to see if, like, I guess like an animal handling test almost to see if she can kind of get closer, not tame it exactly, but, you know, see if it's a bit friendly.
Yeah, I was just thinking something similar. Like, I was going to ask if I could use, like, give it something like a ration or try and get it out of the, like, being scared of it.
We killed your parents. There's a Pop-Tart.
Shit. Wait, frosted or unfrosted?
I'm an evil person. I give unfrosted.
Oh.
We might as well just kill it now and put it out of its misery.
No, you could, like, take it to town and, like, and or put it out in the woods with...
I mean, because he's trying to give it an unfrosted Pop-Tart.
Oh.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
That's essentially death.
It's backing away.
It's fearful of the Pop-Tart.
Fucking Pop-Tart.
It's not going to come after us. I could try to capture it and sell it in town. A little scared, though.
Sell a bear.
Might be more trouble than it's worth. Yeah, dancing bears and stuff, you know? Roaches.
Dancing bears. I wanna... What if I just wanna, like, throw some bread to it? Animal handling again?
That would be an animal handling check, yes.
Okay. Let's see.
Where are you throwing it?
Like, relatively, like, in between... Like, oh, geez. I would've had to move up. So I would've moved up and, like, thrown it, like, midway between me and it. So it would've had to come forward, but not, like... Not on my top, on top of me. Yeah, like there. Just so it's like, obviously, like, it's not showing some sign of like, hey, here.
It's eating the bread.
Are those toaster strudels?
To squeeze your own frosting? Yes.
Serena, do you want to try and, give it a go? I mean, it seems to be responding positive.
No, I think that the bears should eat what bears eat, and maybe not our food.
Okay. With that, I would probably want to, like, try and follow the path to the left and leave it as is.
Yeah, I would kind of be, like, inching my way towards the end, just being like, alright, leave it be.
Yeah. We're fine leaving it be.
Yeah,
now it's going to come back to me, bear the revenge.
And if it follows you kids home, I swear.
I can't bear this depression.
So I'm going to kind of... wow, Richard. Wow. I'm going to make my way over here to the... I think we're all kind of making our way to the left here. Is there any more, or is that it?
That's as far as it goes.
Now, it's like a dead end? Or
no, the cave continues on. And eventually it loops back around to the right. But
okay, so obviously we need to go back out. I do believe this is the end of the cave, and it is not going to end up more And why is the bear playing hide and seek?
Nah, it's going back over there. That's where its bed is.
Bear bed.
Are you saying
we can play hide and go seek with a bear?
If you want to.
Great. Just don't stab it accidentally. I would say, okay, I think we've reached far enough into the cave. There's obviously nothing here. We should probably exit the cave and maybe go back to the tavern or go back to...
Oh, no, the cave continues on.
Oh, do we want to keep going then? Like, that's what I was asking. Like,
Yeah.
I mean, we're all fine.
Okay.
Move us forward. Our mom got hurt, didn't they? I don't know if you want to heal up or not.
She got pretty screwed up. Do we want to...
Yeah, I got beat up a bit.
Do we want to take a short rest? Like, sit here and kind of make a small campfire? And, like,
play hide and go seek with a bear?
Play hide and go seek?
Wow. Okay, so while these guys are futzing with this bear, I'm going to meditate myself.
Yeah, well, Richard's like over there playing hide and go seek with a bear. Oh my god, he's actually going to do it. Wow.
Chasing this poor bear we've just traumatized.
So if we take, like, a short rest, I can roll my hit dice to see if I revive any of my health. Is that how it works?
Yeah, you can spend one of your hit dice. You only have one right now. But...
Yeah, I'm going to do that.
Okay. You regain 9 hit points.
Which is bringing me to full.
How the fuck on a D8 did she roll a 9?
You get your con mod to it.
Oh, fuck that!
So while Richard plays with his little new bear friend, I'm just going to meditate over here on a rock and just be, like, at peace with myself and just have fun with your little bear.
Yes. Animal handling.
You should roll, Richard. Roll animal handling. Does a 14 work? Richard's going to have, like, a pet bear with him by the end of this thing.
It's peeking around the corner at you.
I'm going to wave. Do you want to be my new bear friend?
It backs away again.
Aww! Give it that toaster strudel, Richard. Come on! Or that frosted Pop-Tart this time.
I have a bowl of Frosted Flakes.
It's not a tiger.
I see what you did there.
I'm not prepared for this. I'm only prepared for bears and bees.
Anybody else doing anything during your short rest?
I don't think so. I think, well, can't we during a short rest do... There's something we can do as a group, isn't there?
We're not doing that, Richard.
Not that I know of.
We could play hide and go seek with a bear.
You could play hide and go seek with a bear.
Okay. Yeah, no, there's nothing. I just looked through my stuff. There's nothing I have that requires anything. I didn't take any damage, so I'm good. Richard didn't take any damage, I think. I think he got missed both times, right? Or he's like 5 down or something stupid.
No, I'm at 4.
Can I do a test to see if I can get like a worthwhile bear pelt out of these guys?
God.
Wow, you're going to skin the parents in front of the child. That's vicious. That's vicious.
That's cold.
Yeah.
Make a survival check for me.
Watch me totally butcher it. Nice!
You get a pretty nice bear skin off of this.
Okay, wow. Try. I guess I should try the other one then.
We're terrible people.
Oh!
Two! Yes. Two nice bear skins.
Go, Danica!
Can I give a bear a ration?
Dead ones? Or...
Oh, wait, yes. Danica throws him a piece of his mama.
Jesus Christ.
Oh, cannibalism. Wow.
Bear jerky is delicious.
I've never had it.
It is really good. It's more gamey.
That's sad.
Is it better if it's from the... From the parent.
Parents versus the child? Wow. Oh. Wow.
Well, the child should be more tender.
Yeah, obviously.
We need to know this.
And that's when my D&D game got dark.
I swear she's not a murder hobo.
Alright, Richard, let's go. Leave the bear alone. If it follows you, maybe you can keep it. And let's head off to the left.
No, now I wear the skin and pretend to be a skinner.
Oh, jeez.
No.
Wow. No. So I think we're moving further in, Logan.
Okay, the cave continues on for a while, and then it loops back to the right, and you eventually come out on the other side of that blockage, about 1 or 2 miles down. It definitely took you a lot longer to get through this cave than it would have if you could have just taken the road straight, so it's about midday when you finally get out of the cave. And that will bring you back to the world map.
So I think she would be all like, okay. Alright, well, at least we know where we are, and we can see where we're headed, and let's get back on track.
The bear did not follow you.
Aww.
Would I be able to extinguish the torch to save it, or is it spent after all this?
The torch?
Yeah.
Torch wasn't even lit.
Oh, wasn't? I didn't know how his fire thing worked.
It's not actually fire. It's like a magical ball of light.
Oh, okay. Then
you can cover it, but you can't put it out. Save it.
I just tuck it back into my bag, then all blue and stuff.
Okay.
And further, everybody agree that we're moving towards town still? We're still on that?
Yes. Yeah, yes. We get our bearings and head on our way.
Okay. Yeah.
Thank God we got our bearings.
Bear.
Oh god, I didn't even think about that. Oh god, I'm just brilliant. I am.
Puns.
Wow, the puns.
I can't believe I did that.
So I think we're migrating towards town then. We're heading back towards town.
Okay. You would judge from how far you've traveled so far that you're about a day's worth of travel away from the capital by this point.
Holy crap. Long walk.
It's a good 3-4 days.
Okay.
This road is safe.
Yeah, remember that. This road is safe.
It's barely safe, guys.
Air quotes.
You ran into a fucking giant spider and a couple bandits. That's not safe.
Two bears, a baby bear.
Well, that was your own. They weren't doing anything to you. You went into their home.
I guess. All right.
That's like me running into some guy's house, killing him, and then saying, man, this is a dangerous neighborhood.
Well, you're not wrong.
Yeah,
no, it is a dangerous neighborhood. There's someone who goes into people's homes and kills people.
Right.
Yeah. Wow. All right, so what? I guess we're making our way, right?
Making our way downtown.
Face is passing, we're homebound.
Oh, God.
Alright.
I would say we would probably adventure on unstricken of a fight coming up till dusk time, and then make camp and kind of, you know, set up tents and bedrolls and kind of relax for a little while.
Yeah, the sun is starting to set, and there doesn't seem to be... You haven't passed any inns or taverns, and there doesn't seem to be any in front of you that you know of.
Well, I'm fine with stopping in, setting up a tent, and putting out my bedroll and going to sleep for a while. Do we want to do a sleep order or a watch order, or are we just going to hope for the best?
Better set up a watch. You know, these monks, shifty fellows, can't trust them too much. He says with kind of a wink and a nod, just, you know, kidding around. I'll take first.
I'm guessing that was kind of aimed at my character.
Did you see that?
So you're the only monk.
Oh, you did say monk. I couldn't hear it, so I was like, what's up, Emmy? Since I'm so, like, oblivious to how people really act, I just kind of, like, look around like I don't know really what's happening.
So Danica, volunteer for first watch. You volunteers?
I'll be up later.
I'll
waiting for a bear.
So who's taking first? Is anyone claimed first yet?
Danny,
okay, who's second?
I guess I can.
Okay. Who's third?
I'll take third then.
Okay. Then I'll take the following.
So whoever's first, make a perception check.
Chris just said, hey, I'm here. Ended up having to stay late at work unexpectedly. Had no way to let you guys know. Sorry.
Yes.
Hey.
I hide my bear skins.
Don't want him taking them.
Yeah, he's gonna get all jelly. He's gonna be like, oh my god.
We care to kill the bear family and spare the cub.
He spared something when he wasn't here.
Yeah.
In fact, we did the worst morally correct thing.
While he was not here, so we're good.
Yeah.
Oh my god. Really? You and that perception. Damn!
You don't see or hear anything that strikes you as odd.
Okay. Well, I guess, as long as my watch passes, when the time comes, she'll wake up the second watch and head over to her bedroll and try to fall asleep. Trust these guys well enough, at least. Just say I haven't seen anything. I assume nobody passed by or anything like that.
Right.
So, nothing's happening.
This ambience.
Who is next?
Me.
Okay, make a perception check. You don't see or hear anything either. It seems very... very quiet.
No bear cub?
No bear cub.
Aww.
Literally what you're hearing right now is what you're hearing.
TV?
TV. Yes, the TV.
It's like one of those portals from Bioshock or something.
So... I have a feeling Richard's going to take off in the middle of the night and go get the bear cub.
You all wake up, I'm holding a bear.
He comes back carrying a bear. We're like, what the fuck?
Guys, I found it.
So
when
Richard would come to wake me up, then I would inquire about the bear. I'd be like, did your bear friend join us?
Aww.
No.
I'll keep an eye out for it, okay? And let me roll mine.
God damn, Eagle Eyes out here.
Jeez.
Cat rolls a one.
You're leaving it up to me to fail, I was just going to say. Alright, so she's going to wake me up. She went to the bathroom. She's going to wake me up. I'm going to start my watch. She's going to go to bed. And I'm going to roll mine. Yeah. What did I tell ya?
You don't hear anything or see anything out of the ordinary.
Okay. So after I think you guys get up and I get up, we would, I guess, start back on the way. Yeah. Are we? Did Vance on here or no?
He's eating first.
He's eating first. Yeah. Okay. So I think we would all make our way to town. I think Nick had a question about, is that considered a long rest?
Yes.
Okay, so that is a long rest. You get your hit dice back.
Correct.
So, we would make our way, continue on down the road to town. I would want to stop and make sure my water thing is full, because I think I drank out of it the other day.
Yeah, you can eat. There's occasional, like, rivers and ponds and things along the way that you can refill on, if need be.
Okay.
Once we all wake up, I let Richard know that I didn't see his bear, just to let him know.
Sitting up 2 euros down his cheek.
Wounds now. Yeah, I didn't see what you're looking for.
Yeah, I didn't see what you wanted. Deepest down, you're gonna have to cry about it now and walk away.
Here's some bear pelts.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
How would humanity react?
Okay, morning light.
I actually probably would be so oblivious to how people actually act with each other. I'd probably be petting Danica's bear pelts as I say this to him. Like, I don't see your bear.
Even Danica's like, dude, that's fucked up.
Wow. I say we get packed up, get our stuff on, and get going. I think, you know, we might be able to reach it by end of day today.
Out of character, should we take a break until Van gets here? Just because it's kind of a start of a new day and stuff?
We could take a little bio break, maybe.
Yeah, sure. We could take a little bit of a break.
Yeah, I gotta get some water anyhow.
Okay.
So I'll be back in 5-10 minutes?
I would probably say... on the hour, on 9 o'clock my time, Eastern, or whatever it is for you guys.
Yeah, give it 10 minutes.
Central time.
Yep. Okay. All right, see you guys in a bit.
All right.